If you're a fan of Casual Geographic, aka the GOAT, you've likely learned that the dolphins' cute and cuddly appearances are a bit misleading. After all, dolphins are just animals and not necessarily good or evil. But some of the rather questionable things they've been caught doing teeter a little too close to the dark side. From beheading fish for fun to harassing other animals and even kidnapping other members of their own kind, dolphins can have quite the nefarious nature. And it's no surprise that the top predator of the oceans today happens to be the largest dolphin species alive, the orca. And even orcas can't always use their cuteness factor to get away with their cetacean crash outs. From biting the livers out of great white sharks, to ripping out the tongues of baby whales. But if you think modern dolphins are as disturbing as it gets, then you're probably not ready to learn about the dolphins of the prehistoric past. About 25 million years ago, long before the first humans, giraffes, and even the Galapagos Islands, there lived a truly terrifying species of dolphins, Ankylorhiza. This is an animal that even today's most chaotic, war crime-committing dolphins would think twice before messing with, and for good reason. While this animal was only recently described, its first fossils were actually found over 140 years ago. This holotype specimen only consisted of a partial snout retrieved in South Carolina. Originally, its remains were described as squalodon, another extinct species of long-snouted toothed whale. Over a century later, however, a new, far more complete skeleton of the animal was discovered. Paleontologist Robert Bosenecker and his team recognized that both the original fossils and the new specimen were a perfect match. And they reached the conclusion that this animal represented an entirely new genus. Thus, by 2020, they released a publication about the animal assigning the new species name, Ankylorhiza tiedemani. Ankylorhiza translates to fused roots in reference to the strange, forward protruding teeth of the species, which we will get to shortly. The species name tiedemani was kept in reference to the man who originally donated the fossils to the museum in the first place. Ankylorhiza had a mix of traits that placed it as an evolutionary middle ground between ancient archaeocetes and modern cetaceans. Its flippers, for instance, still had longer hand bones and fingers compared to modern dolphins, a holdover from its more basal ancestry. Its spine also tells a story of transition. The vertebrae near its organs, like the heart and lungs, were more flexible, allowing for greater maneuverability. But as you move toward its tail, the vertebrae became stiffer, an adaptation for faster and more powerful swimming. In fact, Ankylorhiza was likely faster than similar-sized bacillosaurids. This blend of old and new traits highlights its status as a missing link in whale evolution, showing how cetaceans were fine-tuning their swimming efficiency over time. What made Ankylorhiza stand out more so than its unique mix of traits was its incredible size. With the last of the bacillosaurids having gone extinct 4 to 5 million years earlier, Ankylorhiza quickly rose to dominance and took over the now vacant niche. It was the largest toothed whale known from the Oligocene, with adults measuring up to 4.8 meters or 16 feet in length. To better put this into perspective, this would make Ankylorhiza about the same length as a great white shark of the larger sizes. And there's still the possibility that these animals could have gotten even larger, since we only have a few adult specimens. And as if its imposing size alone wasn't scary, Ankylorhiza's long jaws were equipped with a terrifying set of teeth. Its teeth were long, sharp, and interlocked, forming a formidable trap for prey. Its teeth were massive, conical, and deeply rooted, reinforced with a tough layer of cementum. But what really set these teeth apart from other toothed whales was their orientation. The animal's teeth interlocked like a biological bear trap, perfect for gripping and tearing apart struggling prey. Teeth at the front of its mouth were tusk-like and jutted forward like spears. Even the upper jaw was extra thick towards the front of the snout for added reinforcement. Paleontologists believe that the front teeth were used for ramming into prey, a behavior that's seen in orcas. Only this time, imagine if orcas had spears on the tips of their jaws. Ankylorhiza's robust skull alone made up 20% of its total body length, with attachment points for large temporal muscles. These large muscles suggest that Ankylorhiza had quite a powerful and devastating bite. The known fossilized teeth also show signs of severe breakage and heavy wear, likely due to crushing solid bone when the animal was eating. So imagine you're a prehistoric marine crocodile, Thecachampsa, just swimming around, enjoying life. All of a sudden, bam, you get rammed in the side by a sharp, piercing pain. And before you can even process what just happened to you, you find yourself stuck in this murder machine's jaws. You try to escape, but he just shakes you around like a rag doll until you finally succumb to the pain and the lights go out. Talk about a horrible way to go. I hope this paints the picture for you all back home that almost anything and everything was on the menu for this creature. Built for high speeds, it likely held a similar niche to modern orcas and hunted fish, sea turtles, smaller marine mammals, and anything it could snap up with its slender, toothy jaws. Yet, for such a successful predator, Ankylorhiza seemed to have a rather small range, as all fossils for the animal so far have only been found in South Carolina. The Chandler Bridge Formation particularly represents a warm tropical sea with many different unique animals, from sharks, sirenians, sea turtles, marine crocodiles, and even other cetaceans. Such a productive habitat and a buffet of prey choices was truly the ideal habitat for Ankylorhiza. Sea turtles like Carlino Shelley's might have been on its menu, or at least young of its species might have been. The tough, protective shells of the adults would likely have been too tough for most predators, including Ankylorhiza, to bite through. But babies and young are always easier targets anyways. There were many small whales roaming in the oceans at this time too, but only one rivaled Ankylorhiza in both size and niche, Coronadon. This animal offers a fascinating glimpse into whale evolution. Unlike filter-feeding whales today, Coronadon still had teeth instead of baleen. The front teeth were ideal for catching fish, while the back teeth had a unique adaptation. Small pockets that could trap tiny crustaceans, functioning like a primitive filler-feeding system. This dual-purpose dentition is similar to what we see in modern crab-eater seals and leopard seals today. Coronadon's teeth give us a better look into the transition from teeth to filter-feeding baleen. Yet even these predatory whales were not fully safe from becoming prey themselves. Ototus angustidens was the second largest shark to ever live, only falling short of its more famous descendant, Ototus megalodon. Reaching sizes of up to 12 meters long, double the length of the largest great whites, these massive sharks would have likely fed on Coronadon, Ankylorhiza, and anything that could fit in its massive jaws. Ankylorhiza was a top predator indeed, but the top of the food chain was reserved for the Oligocene's version of jaws. The oceans of the Oligocene were home to an incredible cast of creatures, but few could match the sheer versatility, speed, and danger posed by this beast. Ankylorhiza was more than just a scary dolphin. It was a milestone in cetacean evolution. The animal's terrifying teeth, flexible spine, and its propensity towards violence makes it one of the most fascinating marine mammals of all time. Ankylorhiza stands as a symbol of nature's relentless experimentation with form and function. It's a reminder that even the creatures we think we know, like dolphins, can have a much darker, more fearsome past. And even though the oceans of today can be scary to some, the oceans of the past were much more terrifying. So the next time you're having a bad day, just be grateful you weren't born a Thecachampsa 25 million years ago. Now, Ankylorhiza had only emerged in the first place to fill the roles left vacant by an even more impressive class of beasts, the Bacillosaurids. To learn more about Bacillosaurids, you can check out the previous videos on Bacillosaurus and Parasitus.